Yeah, good afternoon, students.
Good afternoon, ma'am.
Yeah, very good afternoon. Okay, we'll start with the today's class. So yesterday we have discussed about the environmental diseases introduction. So basically under this we have discussed about basically, under environmental diseases, we have come across with the definition of the pollution. So, what is mean by pollution and what are the different ways the environment is getting polluted by different components or different particulate matters or different physical, chemical and biological agents. And how these agents are creating a pollution in the environment. And we have also come across basically in your syllabus it is given about air pollution, so we are not discussing any other pollutions here. Totally we are concentrating on the air pollution. So what is mean by air pollution, what is mean by atmosphere, what are the different types of pollutants are there and how these pollutants are going to contribute in the pollution of the environment. So basically under air pollution, so we have discussed about what is mean by air pollution. Air pollution is nothing but any pollutant which is going to be released into the air, which is going to contaminate or which is going to brought about the harmful or adverse effect on the living system, that we are going to call it as air pollutants. Basically the air pollutant, it could be a physical agent, it could be a chemical substance, or it could be a biological agent. So biological agent is nothing but the microorganisms which are responsible for causing the adverse drug reactions, or it is responsible for causing the ill health on the, or affecting the health of living creatures. So, and what are the like different layers are there and how this atmosphere is related with the air pollution, is how the pollutants which are present in the air, it is going to affect the atmosphere, and how once there is a damage to the atmospheric layer and how this will create a Hill effect or the untoward reactions on the living organisms. Then we have come across with the pollutants. Basically the pollutants are nothing but the agents which are responsible for the substances which are mainly responsible for causing the adverse drug reactions, are responsible for bringing about the ill health. So all these things we are going to call it as pollutants. And basically there are two types. One is primary, another one is secondary pollutant. So what is mean by primary pollutant? Basically the primary pollutant is going to be produced. It is going to be produced either from the industry or from the vehicles, or it is going to be produced when we are burning something. So that pollutants we are going to call it as primary pollutants. Whereas the secondary pollutants are produced. The secondary pollutants are produced when the primary pollutant interacts with the air. So that will be called it as secondary pollutants. Today we will see what are the different components which is going to cause us the pollution to the air. So that is burning of fossil fuels, agricultural activities, exhaust from the industry, mining operations, as well as indoor air pollutants. Regarding this, we have discussed in the yesterday class. We will see what are the ill effects or untoward effects when there is a pollution in the air. So depending upon the extent of pollutants which are present in the air, you are going to come across the adverse effects or untoward effects or harmful effects you are going to see on the living systems. So if you look at the effects which are going to be produced on the living system by the air pollutants, it could cause us any kind of respiratory as well as heart problems. Then will be the global warming, acid rain, then eutrophication, then comes to the depletion of the ozone layer. Actually, regarding all these ill effects of air pollution, we are already facing. So respiratory and heart problems. As you people know that if what the air we are going to inhale, if it get contaminated, so automatically what will happen? the cells, tissues will be deprived for the oxygen. After that, progressively there will be a decline in its functions. So, if you inhale the contaminated air, what will happen? The respiratory functions will be like, it will get degraded, and that leads to asthma, that leads to pneumonia, that leads to bronchitis, emphysema, etc. So respiratory related problems will be increases. Similarly, even with the heart related problems. Then comes to the global warming. So what is mean by global warming? As we already experiencing one or the other way with respect to the global warming. So global warming is nothing but because of the increased temperature in the worldwide, what happened? The sea levels will go high. The sea levels will go high. How exactly the sea levels will go high means, so because of the increased temperature, what will happen? The hill stations are the highest regions. So in part of our world, what will happen? They will get melt. They will get melt. As a result, it will be converted into water, and that water, when it comes into the sea levels will increases. So, and when you can imagine when the ice will melt and convert into water, and that water will enter into the sea, when the sea level automatically when it increases, what could be the disaster which can happen? So recently, almost like 5 to 6 years back, Badrinath Kedarnath, what happened there was, it's a global warming effect only, but still we people are not learning from this thing, the lessons, but still we are doing whatever we want, and we are behind getting what we want. So that is the hill effect of global warming. Then comes to the acid rain. So what is mean by acid rain? Generally, whenever the levels of especially two important pollutants such as sulfur dioxide and nitric oxide. So when these chemical levels, when these gas levels are increased in the air, are increased in the atmosphere, so what happens? These gases will combine with the rainwater. Whenever rain comes now, during that time, these gases will be mixed up with the water, and finally they will make the rainwater into acidic. And when this rain falls on the ground, so that will destroys the crops. That will, for example, if it falls on the land, it will destroy the land. If it falls on the any kind of monuments, the monuments will get destroyed. If it falls on human beings or any kind of living organisms, it will causes the erosions or burns on the skin. So this is called as acid rain. Then the another very important ill effect that we are going to observe because of the air pollution, especially which is going to be associated with the nitrogen gas. So that phenomenon we are going to call it as eutrophication. So eutrophication, eutrophication. What is mean by eutrophication? Anybody knows what is mean by eutrophication? Anybody knows what is eutrophication? Okay, so eutrophication, it is a condition where whenever the high levels of nitrogen in the atmosphere, that means when the nitrogen levels in the atmosphere, when it goes high, so this nitrogen will get deposited above the sea surfaces, and that will be turned, that nitrogen gas will be turned into an algae. And this algae, that is whatever the nitrogen gas which is settled above the sea, which is going to be turned into an algae form, this will cause an adverse effect on the aquatic creatures. It could be a fish, it could be a plant which is staying over there. And this generally, this green colored algae, whatever we are going to see on the lakes, ponds, is mainly because of the presence of this chemical, that is nitrogen. So whenever the nitrogen levels in the atmosphere increases, this nitrogen will try to settle above the sea area on the sea surface, and later it will slowly turn into a algae green color, and this will chemical is going to cause a untoward or adverse effect on the living creatures, especially on the aquatic creatures. So that phenomenon we are going to call it as eutrophication. Eutrophication is basically resulted because of the chemical nitrogen N2. So next comes to the depletion of the ozone layer. So as we know that ozone layer is present in the stratosphere, which plays a very important role, So generally this ozone layer, it is going to protect human beings, the living creatures which are on the earth, against or with respect to the harmful UV rays. So when this ozone layer gets keep on depleting, especially the usage of the refrigerator, the usage of the AC, so that will release us a chemical. That chemical is, that is CCF, that is chlorofluorocarbons. So when these chemicals are going to be in a high amount, it is going to be emitted into the environment. This chemical has the ability to damage the ozone layer. So when the ozone layer get depleted, so what will happen? So it will create a pore. Because of this chemical, a pore is going to be created on the surface of the ozone layer. Hence, so whatever the rays which is coming from the sun, which is to filter by the ozone layer, that will not happen. So directly the sun rays will come and falls on the earth. So that means on us people. So what will happen if the light is not filtered? If the light is not filtered by the ozone layer, so directly we are going to get exposed to the light rays which is emitted from the sun. So that contains a harmful ultraviolet radiations. So if this ultraviolet radiations, if it comes directly in contact with us, so what will happen? So under physical carcinogenesis, we have come across, so radiations, how it is responsible for causing the cancer. So it may causes the cancer, or it may causes any kind of the skin diseases. So this is the how the air pollutants will causes the ill effects on the living system or on the humans. So then comes to the, what are the major pollutants which are going to be produced by the human activities? So generally, if you look into the primary pollutants, so under primary pollutants, we have sulfur dioxide, we have nitrogen dioxide, we have volatile organic compounds, ammonia, radioactive pollutants. So these are the different types of primary pollutants which are going to be produced by the human activity. That means in one or the other way, we are responsible for the production of these primary pollutants. So sulfur dioxide, if you look at the sulfur dioxide, it is a chemical compound with the chemical formula SO2. And basically this chemical substance, it is going to be produced. This chemical is going to be produced in various industries. This sulfur dioxide is going to be produced in various industries, especially the coal, petroleum industries. They are going to produce, are they going to deal with the chemicals which contains sulfur as a very important component. So when they do the combustion, so it is responsible for the production of SO2. So SO2, it is going to be mainly produced by the chemical industries, which are mainly deals with the coal, petroleum products. Apart from that, even this SO2 is also produced by volcanoes. So, and whatever this SO2 which is going to be formed, whatever this SO2 which is produced, when it combines with the water molecule, this is responsible for the production of the acid rain. SO2 combines with H2O, gives rise to H2SO4, which is called as acid rain. That means one of the important component of the acid rain is your SO2. Then comes to the nitrogen dioxide or nitrogen oxide. So this nitrogen dioxide or nitrogen oxide are basically produced when you combust something at a very high temperature. And during the thunderstorms, so whatever the electrical discharges will be there, you know, during before the rain, sometimes we can listen to the thunderstorms. So during that, whatever the electrical discharges which is going to be emitted, even that contains the high amount of this chemical substances. And this is also one of the important component of a acid rain. Then comes to the volatile organic compounds. So basically these volatile organic compounds are well known to be as a outdoor air pollutants. They are well known to be as a outdoor air pollutants, and they may be includes your methane and non-methane compounds. Generally, this methane is extremely efficient greenhouse gas, and this is going to be contribute to enhance global warming. So other than this methane, whatever the other volatile organic compounds are there, and even these volatile organic compounds are also responsible for the significant greenhouse gas. What is mean by greenhouse effect?
Increase in the earth's temperature.
Sorry?
Increase in the earth's temperature due to trapping of gases.
Okay. Any other answers? Can anyone tell what are the greenhouse gases are the gases which are responsible for producing the greenhouse effect?
Carbon dioxide.
Yes.
Methane.
Yes, methane, nitrous oxide, and even the ozone. So all these are the different gases which are responsible for producing the greenhouse effect. Generally, as she said, so generally the greenhouse gas is a gas which is going to absorb and emit the radiant energies. And this absorbed energies are within the infrared range. You people might, if you have started with your analysis, you will be knowing the frequency sequence of these ultraviolet radiations, infrared radiations. So within that range only, you're going to come across these greenhouse gases. And the major gases will be your carbon dioxide, methane, nitrous oxide, as well as ozone. What is the chemical formula for ozone?
O3.
Yes. The chemical formula for ozone. So apart from this volatile organic compounds, even ammonia is another important air pollutants. So from which particular source, ammonia is going to be released into the environment?
Ma'am, fertilizers.
Yes, ammonia. It is going to be released into the atmosphere or into the environment during our agricultural processes. Generally, this ammonia, it is a main component of your urea. So whenever we increase the usage of these chemical substances in the agricultural processes, so this particular chemical is going to be... So generally, during the agricultural processes, this particular chemical is going to be produced. And this ammonia, apart from the agricultural fields or agricultural processes, so this particular chemical substance, it is also a component. It is also a component in many pharmaceuticals during the synthesis. So apart from this ammonia, another important chemical substance which is a major pollutant of the hair, that is radioactive pollutants. So generally these radioactive pollutants are going to be produced during the nuclear explosions. Apart from these nuclear explosions, during the nuclear events, war explosions, and natural processes such as radioactive decay. So during this phenomenon, we can see the emission of the radioactive substances into the air. So these are the important chemical substances which are produced by the human activities during the different phenomena. So it could be a sulfur dioxide, nitrogen dioxide, or nitric oxide, volatile organic compounds, ammonia, and radioactive pollutants. So next will be the secondary pollutants. So what is meant by secondary pollutants? Secondary pollutants are going to be produced whenever the primary pollutants interacts with the environment. So during that particular time, you can see the secondary pollutants. So under secondary pollutants, we have photochemical smog, and second one will be the ground level ozone. So what is meant by photochemical smog? Anybody?
Smog is,
yes,
smog is smoke and fog.
Can anybody give an example for the smog?
Reduce the visibility.
Yes.
Reduce the visibility.
Okay. Anybody heard from Delhi? Anybody? Any students are from Delhi? Are near to that? Too near.
No need is there, I think.
Okay. If not from Delhi, probably we might have, while watching the news, we might have come across in the last year news, the Delhi roads are get blocked because of the smog, because there will be no visibility because of that smog. There is chain accidents have been happened in New Delhi. So this is mainly because of this secondary pollutant effect. Photochemical smog. Smog, it is a mixture of the smoke as well as fog. So that leads to a chemical component or a final component called as photochemical smog. So because of this photochemical smog, there will be a decrease in the visibility. We can't see. So what is there in our front? During this winter season, we know that in the early mornings, during this winter season, generally people who are staying in the hill stations, they will experience more rather than people who are in a Bangalore. So in this environment, if you come out early mornings, so what you can see?
Fog.
But if you go towards the hill stations, you can see, especially either in the early mornings or in the late evenings, you can see the road. Only for few meters only you can see the road. If you want to go further, nothing will be visible. So in that particular case only we feel the difficulty. If because of the smog plus fog, if it is going to be mixed, then it is you can't imagine only the condition. So whatever it is happening in New Delhi, it's all because of the too many chemicals which are releasing into the air. So because of the high usage of the vehicles, so what happened? More and more pollutants are releasing carbon monoxide, carbon dioxide, sulfur dioxide, nitric, everything we are leaving directly into the air. So because of that, air is day by day getting polluted. So secondary pollutants are going to be produced when the primary pollutants interacts with the atmospheric air. So photochemical smog is one of the important secondary pollutants, which is a resultant of smog plus fog. So that gives rise to photochemical smog, and it is a kind of air pollution where you're going to come across smog result from large amount of the coal burning. Generally, while burning the coal, a large amount of the carbon containing compounds are going to be emitted, such as carbon dioxide, carbon monoxide. So apart from that, even the sulfur dioxide is also going to be produced. So when this when this interacts with the atmosphere, so that gives rise to a formation of a secondary pollutant, call it as the smog. Then comes to the ground level ozone. Generally, this is going to be resulted because of the nitric oxide, or it could be because of the volatile organic compounds. And generally, this ozone is a key constituent of troposphere, and it is also an important constituent of certain regions of the stratosphere, commonly known as ozone layer. So apart from these two, another important thing is peroxyacetyl nitrate. Peroxyacetyl nitrate, it is also an very important secondary pollutant, and this is going to be formed by same process, that is nitric oxide and volatile organic compounds. So this is about the primary and secondary pollutants. Now we will see the important ill effects which are going to be produced by the primary pollutants other than your sulfur dioxide, nitric oxide, that is your carbon monoxide. So nowadays, the levels of carbon monoxide in the environment, that is in the air, it is day by day, it is increasing because of the high usage of the automobiles and reduced number of trees. As we know that how we intake oxygen, leave the carbon dioxide, in a opposite way the trees will do. Trees will take up high amount of the carbon dioxide, carbon monoxide, and leaves out the oxygen. Because of the high production of the carbon dioxide, carbon monoxide compounds by increased usage of the automobiles, and because of the reduced number of trees, there is a imbalance existed. And we will see what is this carbon monoxide poisoning. This carbon monoxide poisoning will be important for 2 marks. So you can from this environmental diseases, one question or one important question that you can expect will be from this carbon monoxide. One is acid rain. Other than this acid rain, what is meant by photochemical smog? Then comes with the what is meant by carbon monoxide poisoning. So basically, what is meant by carbon monoxide poisoning? Carbon monoxide, it is a colorless, odorless gas, and this gas is going to be produced during the combustion of the carbon containing compounds. Whenever you burn the carbon containing compounds, so example, it could be your fossil fuels. So whenever you burn the fossil fuels, there you can generate a high amount of the carbon monoxide. So how exactly it looks means, it is a colorless, odorless, and it will not cause any kind of irritation if you inhale. So what are the different sources apart from the fossil fuels? So this carbon monoxide, it is going to be produced by as a automobile exhaust. Second will be, as we know, burning of fossil fuels. And third will be tobacco smoke. So these are the three important components, or these are the three important sources which will generate, which will produce us the carbon monoxide. That we will call it as formation of carbon monoxide. And how this carbon monoxide is going to be produced? Basically, as I mentioned, burning of the fossil fuels. So when the carbon monoxide in a high amount is going to be generated, means whenever you're going to burn the fossil fuels, or whenever you burn the carbon containing compounds in an enclosed room. So in an enclosed room, so what will happen in an enclosed room if you burn something? So what will happen, because of the less availability, or because of the reduced availability of oxygen, so what will happen? Because of the decreased availability of oxygen, there is a incomplete combustion will be takes place, incomplete burning will be takes place, and during this phenomenon it will emits a very high amount of the carbon monoxide. So whenever you burn the compounds, whenever you burn the compounds in an enclosed room, there will be a high emission of the carbon monoxide. So what happens because of this high carbon monoxide? Generally, what is the role of this carbon monoxide on us? What are the ill effects are going to be produced by this carbon monoxide on us? So how exactly this carbon monoxide it is going to interfere with our health? Basically, as we know that the oxygen is important for our cells. Why? Because this oxygen is essential to carry out various metabolic activities. This oxygen is essential for the production of the energy. And this is going to be carried by RBC, or you can call it as hemoglobin, to various cells and tissues of our body. So in this condition, if the levels of carbon monoxide goes high, or whenever you expose to an environment which is rich in high carbon monoxide, during that time what will happen, whatever this oxygen which is bound to, oxygen plus hemoglobin gives rise to oxyhemoglobin. But whenever the levels or load of carbon monoxide is high in the environment, so what will happen, this carbon monoxide will replaces the oxygen from the hemoglobin, as a result carboxyhemoglobin is going to be produced. And this carboxyhemoglobin, gives rise to an adverse effect, means because when this carbon monoxide is bound to hemoglobin, so hemoglobin can't displace this carbon monoxide. Hence, the tissues will be deprived for the oxygen. The tissues could not able to undertake the metabolic activities. So the cells, the tissues will die because of the hypoxia. The cells and tissues will be deprived for the hypoxia. And why the hemoglobin could not able to displace the carbon monoxide, that means it can't replace the carbon monoxide with oxygen, means the carbon monoxide has a very high affinity. The carbon monoxide has 200 times higher affinity for carbon monoxide when you compare with your oxygen molecule. Hence, the bonding will be, that is, a strong bonding is going to be created by the carbon monoxide with hemoglobin. Hence, the oxygen could not able to carry it to the cells and tissues. Hence, the cells and tissues will be deprived for the oxygen. Hence, the tissues will be die by hypoxia condition. And basically, two types of carbon monoxide poisoning can take place. One is acute carbon monoxide poisoning. Another one is chronic carbon monoxide poisoning. What is mean by acute means whenever there is a sudden development of tissue hypoxia and characterized by edema and purple spot due to bleeding. So this is called as acute carbon monoxide poisoning. Acute is nothing but sudden development of tissue hypoxia. And how you can, or what are the signs and symptoms will be associated so that you can identify this is sudden means. So it is going to be characterized by edema as well as hemorrhagic condition. So this is called it as acute carbon monoxide poisoning. What is meant by chronic carbon monoxide poisoning? Chronic carbon monoxide poisoning is nothing but, so basically, it is going to be developed slowly. And causes the hypoxia to the brain. And the signs and symptoms which is going to be precipitated, it will be very severe. So it could be headache because of the hypoxia to the brain cells. So what will happen? So the brain cells will be deprived for the oxygen in order to increase the blood supply. Sometimes the changes in the circumference of the blood vessels will be takes place, which leads to the condition called as headache. Sometimes there will be a dilation of the blood vessels in the brain that leads to headache, nausea, vomiting, and because of no hair, no oxygen or decreased oxygen levels, so the cells will be deprived. They will be in a confusion, and a condition called as vertigo can be experienced. And depending upon the extent of hypoxia, tissue hypoxia, there will be a state of unconsciousness or change in the state of consciousness. And because of the hypoxia, there is a weakness can be observed. Really, there is a weakness can be observed. So these are the certain signs and symptoms can be observed. So what is mean by carbon monoxide poisoning? Carbon monoxide, it is an colorless, odorless, non-irritant gas. This gas is going to be produced during the burning of the fossil fuels. Apart from burning of the fossil fuels, even the automobile exhaust leaves lots of carbon monoxide. Even the tobacco smoke leaves the lots of carbon monoxide. So generally, whenever you want to burn the carbon containing compounds in an enclosed room, the amount of oxygen levels will be very less. So this causes the imbalance, or this causes the changes in the amount of oxygen and carbon dioxide level. So this leads to incomplete combustion. This leads to incomplete combustion. As a result, more and more carbon dioxide or carbon monoxide is going to be produced. And whatever this carbon monoxide is going to be produced, it is going to be binds with the hemoglobin by replacing the oxygen molecule, because this carbon monoxide has 200 times higher affinity with hemoglobin than compared to your oxygen, and causes the tissue hypoxia. The carbon monoxide poisoning is of two types: acute, it is sudden; chronic, it is slowly, it is going to be develops. The signs and symptoms will be headache, nausea, vomiting, altered state of consciousness, weakness can be observed. Then how you can diagnose the carbon monoxide poisoning? So the only way to diagnose the carbon monoxide poisoning is by estimating the levels of carboxyhemoglobin in the blood. By finding out that, you can confirm the poisoning is due to carbon monoxide. So treatment. So whenever a person exposed to a carbon monoxide or carbon monoxide gas, so the person will be associated with the